moving along in our discussion about the time value of money, we've already talked about future value and present value and finding those numbers, as well as finding the periods and the interest rate. But instead of talking just about lump sum amounts, we also need to move our discussion toward annuities. Annuities are periodic payments or receipts, which may be called rents, of the same amount, the same length interval between these payments, and compounding of interest once each interval. So the important part here is to remember that the difference in a lump sum and an annuity is lump sum is a one-time payment. An annuity is the same amount paid over the life of the instrument that we're talking about. So every 5 years or every 10 years, we're paying the exact same amount, and interest is compounded over those payments. There's three types of annuities we're going to talk about. And the one that we're going to talk about in this video will be the first one, which is ordinary annuities. This is where the rents occur at the end of each period. And in the next video, we'll talk about annuity due, which is where the rents occur at the beginning of each period because they are different and they're treated differently. And the last one we'll talk about will be the deferred annuity, which is actually a combination of both lump sum amounts and annuities. So let's start our discussion with the future value of an ordinary annuity. This is where, again, the rents occur at the end of each period. So if you look at our timeline here, you see that we're going to make our first payment at the end of year one, and then our second at the end of year two, and so on. So what happens here is there's no interest earned or incurred, depending on what side of the annuity you're on, during that first year. Okay, and then the last payment is made at the end of the last year. So let's look at an example of the future value of an ordinary annuity. So what is the future value of five $5,000 deposits made at the end of each of the next 5 years, earning interest of 12%? Now, if we did not know, due to the title of this slide, that this is an ordinary annuity, we would be able to figure that out because it tells us that we're going to make these payments at the end of each of the next 5 years. And because they're at the end and they're equal payments, we know that this is an ordinary annuity. And since they're asking us what will we have at the end of these 5 years, we know it's a future value question. So looking at our timeline here, we want to know if we deposit $5,000 at the end of the next 5 years, what will we have at 12%? What will we have at the end of those 5 years? So the first thing we have to ask ourselves is what table do we use? Well, we've decided that's the future value of an ordinary annuity. So therefore, we can use the future value of ordinary annuity tables. So we take our table, and we've got to find that factor that we've been talking about in previous videos with present value and future value. We know it's 12% rate, and we know it's 5 periods. So we go to our 12% column, and we scroll down to 5 periods. And we find the factor to be 6.35285. We multiply that times the amount of each deposit that we're going to make. Remember, this factor incorporates everything. The interest rate, the number of periods, and the number of payments. So all that's factored into that. And we multiply that factor times the number of deposits, and we find that if we make a deposit at the end of the next 5 years of $5,000 at 12%, we will end up with $31,764. Okay, so let's let you try one. Here we have the Gomez Incorporated Company will deposit $30,000 in a 12% fund at the end of each year for 8 years, beginning December 31st. What amount will be in the fund immediately after the last deposit? So again, the first question you have to ask yourself, is it a future value or present value? Well, they're wanting to know what will we have at the end of these 8 years, so that's a future value question. We have to know if it's a lump sum or an annuity question, and because it says that we will deposit $30,000 at the end of each year, that makes it an annuity. And then is it an ordinary annuity or an annuity due? And it tells us that we're going to make these deposits at the end of each year. That makes this an ordinary annuity problem. So therefore, we're going to use our future value of an ordinary annuity tables. So I would like for you to calculate what we will have in 8 years, making a $30,000 deposit at the end of each year at 12%. So press pause on your player, go find out the answer, and come back and we'll look at it together. Okay, so you should have your answer by now. So we're going to go to our future value of an ordinary annuity tables. And we know that the interest rate is 12%, and this time there's 8 periods. So we find our 12% column, and we scroll down until the 8th period, and we find our factor to be 12.29969. And again, your table may be slightly different, less decimal places. They may round differently. So as long as you've got the same place in your chart, we should be fine. So taking that factor times the $30,000 deposit each year, you don't sum all those deposits up. It's just, you remember, that factor incorporates all that information in it. So you only multiply the factor times the deposit amount that you're going to make each year. So the $30,000 times the 12.29969 shows us that at the end of 8 years at 12%, depositing $30,000 at the end of each of those 8 years, we will end up with $368,991. So just as we saw with the future value and present value questions of a lump sum, sometimes we want to find other amounts. So for example, if I know what I want to have at the end of so many years, and I know what my interest rate would be, can I find out how much I would need to deposit each year to end up with that amount? Well, assume that you plan to accumulate $14,000 for a down payment on a condominium apartment 5 years from now. For the next 5 years, you earn an annual return of 8% compounded semi-annually. How much should you deposit at the end of each six-month period? So here's our timeline here, and we know what we want to have at the end of these 5 years, but keep in mind, we are compounded semi-annually now. So because we're compounded twice a year, we don't have 5 periods, we have 10 periods. So we have 2 periods every year. And the annual interest rate is 8%. That means we have to divide that in half, because now, remember, 8% is an annual return. If we got 2 periods per year, that means it's only 4% per period. So that's how we get that semi-annually compounding there. So when we use this information to figure out what that payment would be, we're just going to set up an algebraic expression. So for the future value of an ordinary annuity is equal to your rents, which we can call payments, times that future value factor of an ordinary annuity at a certain number of periods and an interest rate. Well, we know that the future value that we want is $14,000. We're looking for the R, which is our rents or our payments, whatever you want to call it. And we've got a future value factor that we need to look up in our table at 10 periods and 4% interest. Okay, so we doubled our periods because of semi-annual compounding, and we halved our interest rate because of that semi-annual compounding. So if we look in our chart at the 4% column, go all the way down to 10 periods, we find the factor to be 12.00611. We want those rents or payments on one side by themselves. So we divide both sides by that factor, and we find out that our payment is $1,166.07 per period, which again is twice a year now, every 6 months. We would need to deposit that amount, earning 4% or 8% semi-annual compounding, to be able to end up with $14,000 at the end of 5 years or 10 periods. Well, similarly to this question, we may want to know, well, if I know how much I want to end up with, and I know how much I can deposit each month, and I know what my interest rate is, maybe I want to know how many payments I'll actually have to make, or how many deposits I'll actually have to make to end up with that amount. So that's the computation of number of payments or periodic rents. So suppose that a company's goal is to accumulate $117,332 by making periodic deposits of $20,000 at the end of each year, which will earn 8% compounded annually while accumulating. How many deposits must it make? Well, again, we can use a algebraic expression to solve for this. So now we have our future value of an ordinary annuity, which we know is equal to our payments times a future value factor of an ordinary annuity. Well, we know the future value is $117,332, and we know the amount of the payments is $20,000. What we don't know is that annuity factor, which we've got to calculate. Then we can go to our table. So if we solve for that annuity factor, that unknown amount, we'll divide both sides by $20,000, or the payments, to get the annuity factor on one side by itself. and we find the factor to be 5.86660. So now that we've got that factor, we can go into our future value of an ordinary annuity tables, and we'll go to the 8%, because that's what we're earning, so we'll go to the 8% column, and we're going to look for that 5.86660, and then scroll over to find the number of periods, and we find that we would need to deposit $20,000 for 5 years, at the end of each year, for 5 years, at 8% interest, to accumulate $117,332 by the end of that period.